their YouTube. Hey, I got a comment the other day, because I believe in proactive humiliation. That's the first reason I don't wear makeup in most of my videos. So, when I put makeup on, yeah, I look hot. but not really. I'm just teasing you. but also, the person asked why I am in a wheelchair. And I don't have a problem talking about it at all. But I need to bring this up. I have a friend who doesn't want to talk about it at all. His statement when people ask him why he's in a wheelchair, he says, "You met me like this, like me like this." Because it's true. Like, once, no matter why we're in wheelchairs, I mean, the fact is, like, you're there, you know? So, if you don't want to talk about your disability, don't push it. Like, don't ever push someone to talk about, like, why they're in a wheelchair, okay? Which this person that commented on my video didn't, that was all fine and wonderful and loving and stuff like that, but even if you are fine and wonderful and loving, even if you really care about someone and you're just so curious as to why they're in a wheelchair, it's not your business, so get over it. Like, they're there and realize that, okay? But if you want to ask, I don't have a problem at all with you asking, like, one time. Okay, whether it's me or someone else, if someone asks me, why are you in a wheelchair? Then I say, oh, I have multiple sclerosis, I broke my hip, I broke my foot, I'm safer in a wheelchair. That's what I say. If it's a little kid, then I say, oh, my legs don't work. And leave it at that. If it's a, or, you know, I can say I have multiple sclerosis to the kids, too, but, you know, they don't get that. So I usually just say, oh, my legs don't work, but it's okay, because I like being in a wheelchair. It's fun. And then I show them all the cool stuff it can do if they have time. but anyway, so, yeah, obviously, I don't have a problem at all talking about my disability. I'm completely open with that. As you can see, I make videos about incontinence and, you know, I've talked about, like, losing bowel control or bladder control or whatever. Like, I am a very, very open person. However, not everyone is. And, for those of you out there, like, I think that the way that it was brought up by the commenter, just, hey, why are you in a wheelchair? Like, I mean, it wasn't exactly that, but, anyway, it was nice and polite and respectful and stuff. I think he said, I'm beautiful. I'm beautiful. Why are you in a wheelchair? Because, you know, pretty people shouldn't be broke. I'm just teasing about that, too. Like, I think there is something so incredibly attractive about people with disabilities, just, like, you know, just for numerous reasons. But anyway, you know, that's neither here or there. Like, what I'm getting at, if somebody doesn't want to talk about it, don't push it and don't try to figure it out on the computer. Like, it's none of your business. Just get over it. But if someone is really open, like I am, then, yeah, learn about it, because I believe, personally, I think talking about my disability and talking about why I'm in a wheelchair and all that, I think it's good for me. I think it's good for me, and I think it's good for the world. Like, in general, I think that we need to be open and honest about life, you know, instead of pretending like everybody is okay all the time. I mean, let's get real. You know, that would be a nice change. And so, anyway, that's, I don't know, that's the way I feel. But there are other people who don't feel that way. So, you know, just let them be who they are and let me be who I am, you know. And some people think that being so open online is, sorry, my pain, that being so open is a bad thing. You know, I have kids, is it really healthy for them to have a mom with a YouTube channel where she talks about peeing her pants? You know, like, I don't know, is that a healthy thing for my kids? Well, you know what, I believe it is. I believe honesty is a healthy thing, and I think that it's something that we don't really have anymore, but I think that privacy is also a really important thing, and something that we don't have anymore. So, you know, be respectful when this question comes up in your life, or if you're asking it, be respectful and understand if people don't want to talk about it, then that's it. Just leave it alone. It's a dead issue. So if you say, why are you in a wheelchair? And someone says, you know, you met me like this, like me like this, then you could be like, hey, you know, that's cool, man. So what's it like? I mean, do you like being able to roll places? Or, like, what's the worst thing? I mean, if you're curious about it, be curious about it. That doesn't have anything to do with why the person is in there. But you can be curious about life once you're in there. Like, that's okay. I think for everyone, like, I mean, and if somebody just doesn't want to talk to you, then leave them alone. Like, don't follow someone around in a grocery store. Say, oh, well, I can help you. I can help you. Like, people do need help. I ask people for help all the time, and there's sometimes when I don't ask for help that people offer it. I'm like, yeah, that would be awesome. But again, I'm a really open person, and so there are a lot of people who don't want help. And so if somebody doesn't want your help, then don't be pushy about it. Help is never pushy. Do you understand that? Help is never pushy. Okay? So, like, if I'm running a marathon in my wheelchair, so rowing a marathon, and I want you to push me across the finish line, which I would, because, first of all, if I'm in a marathon, then, somebody probably pushed me into it in the first place. I did do a MS run one time, but, you know, that was a long time ago, and I did have people pushing me pretty much the whole way. But anyway, so I like being pushed, but nobody likes being pushed around, and nobody likes, if somebody wants your help, then, you know, help them. If somebody doesn't want your help, then go away, leave them alone, which most people do. But there are a few of them that are like, oh, really? I can help you. It's just really sweet. But it's not good. And then, I don't know. I should probably stop this video. It's already getting long. But anyway, I guess those are just a few things about wheelchairs, about the reality of life in it, about talking to people in wheelchairs. Like, you know, we're just people. Okay, this is a big thing. The people who ride around in wheelchairs are just people, like regular old people, just like you and everyone. They just have to use a chair. Their legs don't work. And so, you know, I call it a robot. So we have a robot that rides us everywhere we want to go. But I like talking about it. Some people don't. Also, if I'm in a hurry, I don't like talking about it. Because sometimes I have like 20 minutes before a rainstorm is coming. So I gotta go to the grocery store really quick. So I just am in a hurry. And if I'm in a hurry, I can't talk. So, you know, sometimes people are just busy. They don't want to talk. In a bad mood. Whatever. Come in, Aaron! Hold on. Aaron! Yay!
Hey.
Hey.
How you doing?
Good. Aaron, you should say hi to YouTube. Yeah, just really quick. Say hi.
Hi, YouTube.
We're here. This is my hero. He's on my website. Go to Dine With Style. Thank you. You're awesome. Yeah, I left the door unlocked because I knew you were coming with that. I was like, oh, I hope you just comes in. Thank you.
You have a good day.
You too. Woo-hoo! All right. Package was delivered, and now I'm going to check it out. So, anyway, I'll end this video. Bye.